Con esta calidad me van a ver todos los poros. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. I feel like I haven't recorded in forever, but I'm so excited because I'm finally filming my labor and delivery story. It's kind of crazy because this was actually the first video that I wanted to start my channel off with. So I'm like, oh my God. Now we're here. Keep in mind, this was 3 years ago. My son is three, so I had to write down some notes on my phone so that I could, you know, best remember and, like, you know, make it cohesive. Stay tuned for my next video because I do have a tips video on how I was able to get through the pain and how I was able to go through it without an epidural. I didn't mention that so much in this video because this was just so more so about the story, but the video that I'm filming after this one, it's going to be about the tips and the mentality that I had going into my labor and delivery, which really helped me pull through the pain when I thought I couldn't. So if you want to know how I gave birth, if you want to know how my labor and delivery went, then keep on watching. Okay, so my story begins on May 10th at around 7 p.m. I was set to go to the hospital to get induced. I did have to be induced. Now, I guess this was good because in a way I didn't have to worry about being surprised or, you know, just didn't know when it was going to happen or what to expect. Kind of cool because I knew the time and the day and everything that I was going to go in, and I knew I was going to come out with a baby, right? Obviously, I'm there with my son's dad. His name is Johan, just for, you know, future reference. So around 9 p.m. is when I got my IV inserted, and they also started me on the Pitocin, as well as they inserted like a, what is it called? A cervix softener. Also, sorry if my medical terminology isn't on point because obviously it's been a while. I also had the belt around my belly, put in all that good stuff, and then we just kind of, it was just kind of a waiting game. So like I said, this was around 9 p.m. and around 10 p.m. is when my mom showed up because obviously she wanted to visit us while we were there getting settled in. I did want her and my sister to be present during my labor and delivery, but I asked the doctor when she was checking me and putting the IVs and all that stuff in, I asked her around how long she thought this whole process was going to take, and she said around 12 hours. So I was like, girl. She told the same thing to my mom and everything, so they kind of left home and they told me to, you know, keep them updated and let them know as soon as it was about to happen so they could come in and, you know, be there with me. And nothing really happened for a while. I didn't feel any contractions or anything, but around 11-12 is when I actually started to feel like I had like little cramps, you know, like the menstrual cramps that a lot of people describe these little contractions to feel like. I had a little bit of back pain at this time, so it just kind of, it was kind of uncomfortable, but nothing really major. It was kind of like I felt like I was on my period, and that's basically what it was. So around midnight is when my water actually broke. It actually broke naturally, which was interesting. Best way I can explain it that it felt like is like, you know, the bathtubs, how they have that little thing that you could unplug and it goes. Literally, that's what it felt like inside of me. It was like the weirdest feeling ever. And then I felt all this gush coming out, and it was so weird because it's not like pee. It feels like you're peeing, but you can't control it. You know, you can't tighten to stop it from coming out. I remember I told Johanna, I was like, oh my God, call the nurse, my water broke. So he gets up and calls the nurse, and she comes in and she's like, oh my God, yay, you're progressing, everything's going good and everything. So she actually had to change my padding, like, you know how you have to catch the fluids, you're sitting on like little cloths or whatever. She had to change that twice. So I was like, oh my God, I could only imagine, like, had I been out like walking in the mall or like just anywhere in general, like how much water would have came out, like literally like the movie. So I'm kind of glad it worked out that way. don't mind my neck. I get hot, like I break out in hives, and I have like two box lights in front of me, so I can't really do nothing about that, so don't mind that. After she like changed my padding and everything, I asked her if she could check me because I was curious to know, like, okay, it's been a couple hours, been like 2 or 3 hours since my whole process got started, so I wanted her to check me. She said no, that it was gonna be a while to just settle in and not worry about it. Bless her heart, she was such a sweetheart and a darling, but she got on my nerves. I asked her many times to check me, and she just reassured me that I was a first-time mom, that this was gonna take a long time, that it was just the nurse speaking. Yeah, so whatever, that happened. 1 or 2 in the morning, I just remember my pain being worse and getting worse, and I just felt really uncomfortable. Now at this point I was starting to get irritable, and around this time is also when my doctor had sent an anesthesiologist to come talk to me. Now my doctor was a little shady or whatever, because I told her that I wanted to have a natural delivery, and she's like, no, are you sure, like it's 2015, like it's okay, like it's common. She had no faith in me, basically. Now they gave me the whole spiel, which I didn't mind. I guess it was good that I was informed just in case I felt like I really wanted it at some point, but I was so determined to not get an epidural that I kind of just like, whatever, you know. At this point, Johan was feeding me ice. Excuse me. So then he was feeding me ice, and then he was also like putting cold washcloths on my forehead, which I appreciated, and he was just there comforting me. There comes a point where you're in so much pain that anything will set you off and it just becomes unbearable and annoying and you're just so irritated. So that's kind of what was happening with me. After a while, his breathing was getting on my nerves. I was like, can you not? I'm more of like a suffer alone kind of person, or like suffer in silence. So I literally told him to go take a nap. Like I said, it was 2 a.m. I told him to rest, that we had a ways to go, and ya ni lo quería ver. I just was like, get out of my face, please. I know you're trying to help, but you're not, so just go take a nap. And our suite was actually a suite, so we had a bathroom, a shower, a couch, and then like a visit area, my bed, and then like my baby's bed. And I will insert some footage. You guys could get an idea of what it was like. So yeah, I just told him, you know what? So he did. He was on his phone a little bit, and at this point I was just kind of like by myself. I was like focusing on breathing. I was rocking back and forth through these contractions, but I was in pain. It feels like your body is getting ready to break in half. Like, I don't want to scare you guys, but like that's literally what it feels like. And because your whole lower body is in pain, you kind of feel it in your back, you feel it in your abdomen, you just can't really. And I remember like around 3, once again I had asked my nurse if she could check me, and she said no. So I was like really mad at this point, because I was like, I was trying to gauge my pain because I wanted to see where I was at in terms of how much pain I was feeling, because I wanted to be sure that, you know, like I had this. So I just remember like around 3:30, I was like, oh my god, like, no lo voy a hacer. I was just second guessing myself. Like, I couldn't sit, I couldn't stand, I couldn't be on the side. I remember at some point I even asked for like a little bouncy ball so I could like bounce through the pain. And yeah, she didn't want to check me, so at this point I was like, oh my god. But I just remember the last thing that she told me, I was 1 centimeter. So it had only been 3 hours since she checked me. So I was like, oh my god, I can't even take it anymore, and it's only been 3 hours. Like, it has to be 12 hours of this. Like, I was just going in my head, I was like, I might consider the epidural after all, because I literally couldn't take it. I asked her and she said no once again. So again, this nurse asked her if I could go to the bathroom, because it literally felt like I had to go number 2. So she helped me to the bathroom, and I like sat on the toilet and everything, and out of nowhere I like tried to pee, but out of nowhere, you guys, out of nowhere, my body just contracted itself. Like, it just pushed. And it was at this moment that I realized that I had no control over my body anymore. Like, my body knew what it was gonna do. It just knew it was time, and it just pushed. And I was literally caught off guard because I pushed. Like, and I didn't even want to push. Like, my whole body just pushed in itself. And then my nurse saw that, and she's like, oh, I think it's time. And like, all nonchalant, like, girl, what you mean? She's like, no, you're ready, it's time to go. And I was like, I was so like caught off guard, because I was like, what, you know? Johan had fell asleep, so I remember getting out of the bathroom and I was like, wake the fuck up! Like, I was like, wake up, like, he's coming, you know? So he wakes up like terrified, because again, nobody expected it to be like this soon. I thought I was still like at 1 or 2 tops. Like, I was already like 9-10 centimeters like ready to go, because I was already there, you know? Like, but she just never checked me, she never told me, so I wasn't mentally prepared to stop pushing. So I started freaking out, and I was like, call my mom, because keep in mind they went home. It's like, call them. So at this point I'm like getting rushed onto the bed, lights went up, my legs went up, and it was time to go. It was showtime. So I remember like hearing Johan call call my mom, and he was like, el bebé Selene, ya viene, and he just couldn't spit it out. So looking back, that's hilarious. But I was like, get it together, just tell my mom to hurry. I told the nurse, I was like, no, I'm not ready, like, I want the epidural. Like, I like panicked, and that was like my thing. I was just like, give me the epidural now, like, because I freaked out. Like, I didn't know it was gonna be this soon. I got my doctor on the phone, they're like, listen, she's ready, she's already good to go, she's already pushing. So she rushed to the hospital. At some point during this process, I just remember screaming at him, because the nurse had my leg up right here, and then Johan, he was like terrified, you know? So his my leg was on this side, and I remember I was like pushing, I was cramping, I was like, oh, my freaking leg off, like, I was like, get it together, like, I'm cramping, you know? And I'm over here like pushing your baby out, and my leg's like this. So he got it, and eventually I was balanced. But I just thought it was funny. I actually tore all the way down. I'm not sure, I think they have names for the level of severity with your tears, but I know mine was all the way down. And I pushed for around 15 minutes and then my doctor showed up, and literally she showed up right at the nick of time. She worked her magic, I guess. And 5-10 minutes after that, my son was born, 4 in the morning. Once Gio was born and I heard his cry, I just kind of, nothing mattered anymore. Like, the pain didn't matter, the contractions didn't matter. I had him in my arms and I just felt whole. In that moment, life as you know it is changed. Like, you no longer live for yourself, you live for your baby and I guess your partner and everything at the same time. Like, it's your new home now. It's your family. Just a feeling, you guys, that I hope that everybody can experience, even the dads. Like, Johan was crying and it was just an overwhelming feeling, and I just wish everybody could feel it. So that was it. I hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy, don't forget to like and subscribe so you could join our little fam. Don't forget to follow my social media as well if you'd like. I have it down in the description box. Also, if you're a mommy and you're expecting, I wish you a fast and easy delivery. And I hope everything goes smooth and you don't have any complications. And yeah, no matter which way your baby comes out, because I know that's a controversial topic, whatever, I don't want to get into it. But whichever way your baby comes out, I hope your baby comes out healthy and fast and it is a smooth process. For you. If you guys enjoyed this video once again, thank you guys so much for all the love and the support. Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Until next time. Mwah.